animating your Excel data on a facility map in Excel using 3D Maps custom map feature. The goal today is to animate Excel data on a 3D map of your facility. So instead of putting this on the globe like 3D map usually does, we're going to show the data on a facility map of your shop floor, of your warehouse, or in this case, a nursing home. Now look, before we dive in, the one huge requirement here is this is only going to work in Windows versions of Excel. Excel 2016 or newer, it's not going to work on a Mac, it's never going to work in Excel Online. And that's because this trick requires Power Pivot and the Power Pivot tab and 3D Map, and those will never be available on the Mac and never be available in Excel Online. All right, look up here in the ribbon and see if you have a Power Pivot tab. If you don't, a couple of things we want to do. The first thing we want to do is go to File and then Options. Along the left-hand side is Data, and check for this item right here, Enable Data Analysis Add-ins, Power Pivot, and 3D Maps. You'll have to check that. Click OK, restart Excel. If you still don't see the Power Pivot tab in the ribbon, right-click, customize the ribbon. If you did that first step of enabling the data analysis add-ins, then you should have Power Pivot in the list. All right, so choose that, click OK. And again, after you enable those data analysis add-ins, you might have to restart Excel before that Power Pivot shows up. Now that you have Power Pivot, good, we have access to the data model. Back in the old days, the 3D map, or Power Map, it was originally called in Excel 2013, was right here after the charting group. So you'd have something called 3D map there. Unfortunately, now recently here in 2024, they moved it to the data tab, to data model, and hidden it here under 3D map. All right, so you know, look to make sure that you have 3D map or the old name Power Map in one of those locations. Here's the basic steps. First, we need to get a ping or JPEG of your facility. Here's a graphic. This is of a nursing home, dining room here, lobby, and then a series of rooms. And we want to map things to these various patient rooms here. The thing that is horribly time consuming, but you only have to do it once, is take each location on that floor plan and figure out the X and Y location. I'm going to show you how to do that. Add columns to your data for X and Y, and then in the 3D map, we're going to specify an X and Y coordinate and set up the floorplan.ping. My data, the data that I have here, is showing an outbreak of an infectious disease at a fictional nursing facility. We have the date, the room, the bed, and how many events happened, and name over here, right? So I need to somehow convert this room number to an X and Y location on the graphic. If you're gonna try this, you might as well download the workbook that I'm using here today just for this Grid 1000 worksheet. This has the number 0 to 1000 across the bottom. And just somewhere here, we're going to go to Insert, Picture, Place Over Cells from this device, and import your facility map. Okay, and you want to make sure that this facility map is 1000 wide, you know, based on this, right? So with it selected, I'm going to hold down the Shift key and just drag this out till we get to about 1000 for that last room. All right, good. And you'll want to note here how far up we go, right? So this is like around 650 or so for the height. So we're 1000 wide, 650, and I'm jotting that down on a sticky note because later we're going to have to come back and use that information. Okay, with this picture selected, go to the picture format, transparency, and make the picture a little bit more transparent. That way these X and Y grid lines that I have, these are just drawing objects that I have in here. All right, and basically what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to the very first room, whatever that first room is, select the grid line and then drag it. So it's right in the center of that room, and then kind of use that as a guide. So this is looks like it's about 35 for X and maybe just under 400 for Y. So we'll figure out that room number. That's room number 122. So we have room 122, x to the 35, y of 410, and then repeat. This is not any fun to do this the first time. Now the good news is, like, that y is going to stay the same for all the rooms in this side of this hallway, right? So, you know, you can copy that data down. But getting the room number and the x and the y, you know, this took a good hour the first time I had to do it. It's worth it. You know, your facility's not going to change. You're not going to build a new wing every day. So once you've done this, you'll be able to, you know, reuse this data over and over and over. Okay, so here's the original data. It's important that this is formatted as table. So if it's not, go to home, format as table. That's going to change the name of this to something called table one. Come back here to table design and give it any name. I called mine data. The X and Y locations for each room, I formatted that as a table and I called it coordinates, C-O-O-R-D-S. You can call it whatever you like. We're going to add both of these to the data model. So I go to this table, power pivot, add to data model. That will draw this thing on top of your Excel. You can just close that. Come back to the second table, the one with the coordinates, add to data model. See that we get a second tab down here. So here's data, here's coordinates. Again, we don't need this window. It just opens it every time that we add the data model. And then on the data tab, we need to create a relationship between these two. What do they have in common? They have room number. So data model, relationships. I'm going to create a new relationship. So from the data table, there's a column called room, and that's related to the coordinates table. Using the column called room, they figured that one out. In my case, because they happen to be the same, same set of data, same heading. All right, so we've just created in the data model a relationship between these two tables. To use 3D map, once the data is already in the data model, just come out here to a blank section on the data tab, go to data model, 3D map. And they show us that they know about the coordinates table and they know about the data table. Can't figure out which of these are geographic locations, so it doesn't know where to put it on the map. That's okay. We're going to add the X and Y coordinates as the location. So we click add field X, and then they still don't know what X is, so we say it's the X coordinate right here. They don't give us the ability to choose the map yet because the location is incomplete. So we choose add field, choose Y, and choose Y coordinate. All right, there you go. Once you have those two defined as the location, then, and only then, do we have this thing called change to a custom map. Yes. New custom map. And he wants to browse for the background picture, choose our facility map. All right, now we were very careful using my grid 1000 to make sure that the X went from 0 to 1000. And the Y went from 0 to 650 as the height. All right. So I enter all of those numbers and then click apply and see how my rooms are looking. Right. It actually looks like we're just off by a little bit, like everything is a bit too high. So I'm just gonna play with this a little bit, 670 maybe, click apply. Beautiful. Still a little bit off there, maybe 680. Maybe to the left a tiny bit, so maybe 1,010 here, and click apply. There we go. So now those squares are appearing on top of the right room. It's very interesting that these numbers here, if you ever want to build another 3D map, you want these numbers again, and it is super tricky to find this. So I'm going to call this facility map. Click done. All right, so later, if you need to come back and find those settings, they're not over here in this box at all. You have to come to Scene Options, Map Type, choose Change, And then the currently used map is up here with a little gear wheel, and that will get you back in later to figure out which max and min and scale worked for your particular graphic, right? So scene options, I can never find it. Scene options, map type, change, and then the little gear wheel on the current custom map will let you get back to those numbers. It's one of these things that, you know, I do this once a year, right? And being able to remember what I used last time is always tricky. I just want to open last year's file and find those settings, and they're kind of hidden. Okay, good. So now we've defined this custom map. Now it's just a matter of building the information here. So we have the number of events. That's going to be the height. We have the date. We want to animate by time. So the time slider down here is for date. And then to change colors, we can use, I'm going to use name as the category. This legend here always starts out too wide, so I'm going to make it narrower. That heading up at the top, that is right here, this layer one. So I'm going to edit that. I'll say this is patient name. All right, good. And now all of our tools that we have in 3D Map should be available to us. So if I hold down the Control key and roll the wheel mouse away from me, I can zoom in or zoom out. If I hold down Alt and drag up, I can look at it from the ground level, or drag down, I can look at it from directly above. So choose something that looks right. You can also, while you're holding down Alt, drag left to rotate, or drag right to rotate. You can look at it from the back if that would make more sense in your particular data set. So you have full access here. It's pretty cool. You know how this works with the globe, and it also allows you to do the same thing with your facility. Okay, and then because we have dates here, I can animate this data, just let it play. Right, we have a breakout that started here, spread to here. You know, really, even though it started on this side over here, went really off the rails down here on this wing and spread pretty wildly. All right, and of course you can go back to any point in time as you're going through. So these custom maps, anytime I have data that, like, that has some sort of an XY component, or I'm willing to take the time to convert room number to XY component, it's something I always think about as a possible way to present this data using 3D map on a custom map to kind of show how something, you know, rolls out in your facility. I've done this before, talking about sales in a small retail store over time, or busy or not busy. I mean, all kinds of things. You can show movement of data in a warehouse. And again, it's just the tediousness of getting the X and Y location for each location on the map, and then getting that data lined up correctly back here under scene options, map type, and then the gear wheel. You know, just adjusting these numbers so everything falls in about the right spot. All right, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.